Beyond the Boulevard. Silent film star and the most beautiful ghost in New York. Olive Thomas was born October 20th, 1894. She was the eldest of three and moved to New York City in 1914. There, she entered the contest for the most beautiful girl in New York and won. This gained her the attention of magazines, painters, and even Mr. Ziegfeld Follies himself. The Ziegfeld Follies were a troupe of female dancers who wore elaborate, scarce, and risque clothing. It was a burlesque, theatrical experience of sorts. When Olive joined, she gained much success there until she met Jack Pickford. If the name Jack Pickford rings a bell, it's because he was not only a famous silent movie star in his own right, but also was the brother of none other than Mary Pickford. The two married and moved to Los Angeles to continue her career in film. Her film career ranged from 1914 to 1920, and her first film was The Flapper. Olive was the first female in cinematic history to immortalize the look of the flapper, which, if you ask me, is pretty amazing. Although many might not know Olive today, she was a huge star back in her time. Olive would turn out films left and right for Paramount Pictures. She was a pretty big deal. In 1920, however, her and Jack started experiencing marriage trouble. They decided to go on a second honeymoon in order to patch things up. They went to Paris and partied, drank, danced, all their problems away. Or so they thought. After a night of partying, they returned to their hotel room, where Olive described having a severe headache and couldn't go to sleep. According to Jack, he said to her, "Go get some aspirin or some sleeping pill." Olive went to the bathroom, opened the cabinet, and instead of getting aspirin, she took mercury bichloride. Now, you may say, how could she mistake the two? Why was it in the bathroom? Well, back then, mercury bichloride and aspirin had very, very similar packaging, and mercury bichloride was kept in the bathroom as a cleaning supply. In addition, mercury bichloride was also used in small amounts to treat syphilis, and some speculate that maybe Jack was using that as medication as well. You also have to remember that Olive had just come back from partying and drinking, most likely, probably why she had a headache, and she wasn't in the right state of mind to decipher between the two bottles. Olive took mercury bichloride and her system began to shut down. That was on September 5th, 1920. And on September 10th, 1920, in the hospital, Olive died. When Olive passed away, everyone was devastated. It was a huge loss to the movie industry, so much so that even people were questioning Jack. People thought maybe Jack poisoned her, killed her, but after much investigation, autopsies, it was found that he did not. It truly was a fatal accident. Olive was buried in Woodlawn Cemetery, however, many speculate that she is not there. At the New Amsterdam Theater, where the Ziegfeld Follies performed, they have begun construction. After the construction concluded, Olive made her presence known. One night, a security guard was doing his duty, checking the theater, making sure that everything was a-okay, until he felt a presence. He turned over his shoulder and saw a woman dressed in a white beaded gown, green sash, holding a blue bottle. She walked from stage left to stage right, blew him a kiss, and vanished. The security guard alerted his owner, ran, freaked out, called him, and said, "I just saw a ghost, I don't know what's happening." The owner kind of knew what was going on, but didn't want to freak him out just yet. The next day, the owner brought him a picture of Olive Thomas. The security guard had no clue who she was, and when he saw the picture, he could not believe it. That was the woman that he saw that night. Ever since then, Olive has been known to make her appearance to many, many security guards. In fact, it's so popular that she'll flirt with them, say things like, "Hello, boys," or "How are you?" However, she never has made her appearance to a female. All accounts have come from men, proving that Olive was a very flirtatious young lady. So, in order to keep things under wraps, during show times and during the evenings, the owner decided to hire only female security guards during the night shift. And ever since he did this, Olive has yet to make her appearance to a woman. The next account was in 1990, when the theater would bring back original Foley girls before the Broadway show as a way of commemorating and respecting the history of the theater and the women. One man who was backstage at the time was leaving the theater, and he noticed that the brooms and the furniture and the objects backstage were rattling furiously. You could say Olive wasn't too happy with the appearance of her old friends. I mean, she probably didn't realize she was gone. Many people who believe in the paranormal say that when someone dies so abruptly, they have unfinished business and sometimes don't even realize that they're gone. So for Olive to see her friends older, it probably made her realize her reality and scared her and made her very upset. The man looked at the moving furniture, smiled, and just said, "Good night, Olive." Now, it is a ritual that all of the workers in the New Amsterdam Theater must say, "Good morning, Olive," and "Good night, Olive," to a picture of her located at every entrance and exit of the theater. As long as they do this, and as long as they keep construction down, Olive has relaxed a bit in her activity. That was the story of Olive Thomas. Thank you for watching Beyond the Boulevard. Tune in for the next episode for a hauntingly good time.